Hi, you have found Rides with Chuck. Back in 1999, on the way to a shoot, our camera car, Big Red, had a breakdown. We had to call for a tow.
10, go ahead.
I will pick up 3 when you're ready.
Go ahead with the information, please.
Okay, we have a customer, the Taurus Red Wagon. Disabled at Rockway and Calipari Road.
Mark, what do we got here?
Well, what we have here is a 1935 Ford truck. It's a Series 51, which was the classification they gave to the 1.5-ton trucks. Originally was a pickup truck, and we acquired it and made it into a tow truck. Of course, back then in the 20s and 30s, as the towing industry started to come about, most of the tow trucks were built in blacksmith shops. Wrecker cranes or tow cranes were available by several manufacturers, but for the most part the bodies were built in the blacksmith shop to fit the chassis that was being designed or rechanged in order to make a tow truck out of it. This particular one, in 1935, Ford came out with a service car, and the service car had a body on it similar to this one, and it could be used for a wide variety of different things, everything from a service vehicle to a tow truck. A wrecker crane could be installed in the back. And that was kind of the guidelines that I used when I designed this truck, to follow the lines and the body lines and the design of the service cars they had back in 1935. Louis. Once again, it was a pickup truck when we bought it, and they had the visions of making a tow truck out of it. We did a lot of research in body designs of the era. Wanted to try to follow the body designs of that era. We searched across the country for a wrecker body, the back half of the truck, and weren't able to find any. We did find one in Detroit that was sitting out behind a farm. It had been there for some 12 years. The man gladly sold it to me for a very small amount, and I sent my father out to Detroit. He picked it up, brought it here, lost half of it on the way as it was falling apart as it was going down the highway. The rust and the stuff was falling off the truck, but it became a good template. We dismantled the body. Back then the bodies were all made out of wood, and they had a steel overlay over them. It was like kind of a billboard type concept. So it was very easy to dismantle the body, and we used the panels as a template, and we built the entire body originally out of plywood. Got all the lines right, got everything sized the way we wanted it. Theory being, it was a lot easier to throw a piece of plywood away than a hunk of steel if you made a mistake. So once the entire body was in position and all the pieces were placed in place, made out of plywood, then we took the plywood body apart and used that as a template to cut every panel out of steel.
Is this the first restoration project you've ever done?
Yes, it is. It is the first job we've ever done.
This came out beautiful. You're going to make a lot of people jealous.
Well, it's like anything else. I'm not a body man by trade by any means, but I do have a lot of patience, and I do have an eye for detail. So worked on it piece by piece over the course of 4 years, in the free time and the spare time, and did a lot of it at home, a lot of it down here at the shop, and it was took a lot of time to do.
Mark, could you start the engine for us? Well, you must have learned a lot doing this. There's somebody out here outside watching this program now thinking, I'd like to restore an old truck or an old tow truck. What advice do you have for them?
Well, advice I have for them is the problems, the only problems I ran into when doing this truck was that all the chassis components, the suspension, the frame, steering controls, rear axles, etc., so forth, these components aren't available in the aftermarket like a lot of aftermarket parts are available today for the Model A's and even for the 35s and 40s, et cetera, so forth. All the cab sheet metal is available because it's the same cab they use on the half-ton pickups. But when you get into fenders and running boards and, like I say, all the driveline, it's all a creature of its own, and because there's not a real demand for these trucks to be restored, there's not a real source of supply for them.
Well, this thing looks really beautiful, and I can't wait to see it on the road, and I'm sure our viewers would like to see it too. You want to go for a ride in a tow truck? Mark, thanks a lot. Let's take a ride in your tow truck.
Thank you.
Let's go for a ride.